Hey there, I'm Parth Doshi, exploring the field of RPA and sharing my learnings with you by making videos. This is the next video in the playlist of UI Automation Next Activities. In this video, we are particularly going to see an activity of UI Automation Next package, that is Take Screenshot. So if you are doing a web automation or you can say desktop application automation and you want to take screenshot and save some data or save that particular part of the website or the application, how you can do that. So let's get started. Now, to use UI Automation Next Activities, we first need to install a package that is UI Automation Next.activities. You can do that from Manage Packages. Once you have done that, we'll have this particular set of activities in our activities panel. Now, to use any of the activities of UI Automation Next package, we need to indicate an application or a browser. So what are we going to do in this video? In this video, I'm going to scrap the data, or you can say take the screenshot of the data from my YouTube channel. That is, we are going to take the screenshot of this particular part, that is the subscribers. Then we are going to go to the about section, and then we are going to take screenshot of this views. So let's see how we can use that. Now, let me start with first indicating the application. So this is the complete screen I'm going to indicate. Now, once that's done, what we are going to do is we are going to use take screenshot activity. Now I'm going to indicate the element that is going to be this much part. So it is asking me if I want to indicate some anchor, but I don't want to. So I am just confirming it. Now I'm going to save this image in subscribers.png. And now we need a click activity. So as to click on this particular about, again, it will ask me to indicate the anchor, but I'm not going to indicate it. So just confirm. Now, once it clicks on that, we need one more screenshot, which is going to be about this views. So let's go back to UI path, indicate views. Again, an anchor, but we don't want, so just confirm. Now this I'm going to save in views.png. Now after that, what we are going to do is we are going to use navigate browser. So after this process is done, I want to just close this tab. So we have created the complete workflow of taking the screenshot of two particular parts from my YouTube channel. Let me just close this particular web page so we can start the workflow. So let's start the workflow and see if we are able to take the screenshot of the part which we have indicated. So I'm running the workflow. Okay, so now it should open the browser. It has opened the browser. Now it should take the screenshot of it took one screenshot. Now it is taking the second screenshot and the workflow is completed. Okay, so now let's see whether we were able to get, let me just refresh this. Okay, so we have both the images with us. One is subscriber.png. So let's see this image. Okay, so we were, as you can see, the screenshot is very accurate. It has only captured the part which we had detected while building the workflow. Now here also you can see there is no extra part of the screenshot over here. The part which we indicated, that much part is only there. Now let me give you some ideas, like where can we use this take screenshot activity. Since this was very short video, so let me give you some applications. So one application can be, in the previous video of this playlist, I have built a Google form automation. So once the form is built, you can use the take screenshot activity to take the screenshot of that particular. Or else, if you're using a desktop application and you have filled some details and you want to capture that particular part, so at that time you can use take screenshot activity. So these are some of the applications wherein you can build your own use case and make a workflow on how to take a screenshot of different applications or websites as per your application. Thank you for watching the complete video. Please do subscribe to my channel if you haven't done that yet. And do check out the playlist of UI Automation Next Activities in the suggested playlist. Also, please press the bell icon to stay updated to all the new videos I upload. Thank you.